I'm at least at back reporting.
When you did somebody,
well, I just like to say how many to like give him something.
Tell Ricky who you worked with. Amir Khan.
We talked.
Kel Brook.
You know Andre.
Andre Berto.
Yeah.
Who else?
The list, guys.
Anthony Joshua.
Chris Eubank Jr.
Mikey Garcia. Maybe
Billy.
Ricky Funes one day.
How was it over there?
In Vegas?
No, in did you go to San Bernardino?
No, I'm not in Vegas.
Oh, yeah.
What's in San Bernardino?
Riverside.
Oh.
No, I was gonna go, but then they made a few last minute changes to the kit, so they sent it from back home straight there. Otherwise, it would have to come to me to Vegas, and then I'd have to pack a box.
Are you going to New York?
I was gonna go to New York. The plan was to come to Vegas, then come here, then go back to Vegas, then go to New York.
Oh, let's go to New York. We're going. We're leaving next Wednesday.
We're leaving.
Yeah, Wednesday?
Yep.
Yeah,
it's a big
home.
Fight.
I'm supposed to fly home on Tuesday. I was like, I really want to go.
Extend it.
I'm so tempted.
Go to New York. We'll have fun over there. We'll show you a good time in New York.
Yeah.
Have you ever met Anthony Joshua?
I have not.
What can you tell us about him?
He is like, what you see is what you get with Anthony.
So my friend hangs out with his trains. Ahmed trains with his trainer up in London. Because I have my guy from London, he's out here right now.
Okay. Because he trains in Sheffield.
It's a short commercial.
Okay.
Is Sheffield nice?
Yeah, it's good for boxing. My older
yeah.
GP.
Yeah.
Is it quiet in there?
Yeah, why not?
Really
okay.
Small, okay. Yeah, it's
no
not
problem.
Too big. Yeah, Joshua is amazing.
Nice guy?
Yes, super nice guy.
He will have the rematch. It will be in Vegas. What's your prediction? Him, Klitschko, too?
He's done it once, he'll do it again.
It's going to be a good fight.
How about Wilder, Joshua?
Oh, Joshua's my boy.
Yeah, you're sticking with him. Who do you like?
The fans are the winners.
I got Wilder in that one. But Sophie, life's been good.
Very good.
Have you reached out to Connor or reached out to Floyd about making the?
I have made some attempts.
Okay, so you wait. Maybe they'll watch this video and they can reach out to you at Fight Label.
Floyd has worn those shorts recently. I'm sure it must be in his mind. And I don't think he's a guy that would forget when I gave him the shorts the first time. Obviously with Connor, because he ring-walked Michael Conlon into
yes,
New
he did,
York,
he
so
did.
He just stood with
you were there too, I saw.
What size?
Small.
Small, yeah.
3X.
3X. Like it big.
That's what your lady had.
You were there at that fight.
Yeah.
So that's where you met Connor,
yeah.
And you said, "Hey."
Well, I didn't meet Connor in the fight, but obviously Michael was with him, and he walked out. And Michael had the crazy hat on. It was all like Irish St. Patrick's Day stuff, which was.
So you're happy, you're good. What do you tell all the fans, all the fighters, all the managers? Just go to Fight Label, check out your stuff.
Label. Yeah, I just want to kind of turn boxing into the most fashionable thing. That, like, I'm a firm believer in you feel good if you look good. So like that mindset to put it into the fight, I think is so important. So.
Now, I see on Instagram, you've been working out for Japan 2020. Are you making a comeback for the Olympics? Look at me, I'm working out, I'm sweating. You go all out.
Yeah.
You were a skater, right? A figure skater? What's the highest level you competed?
Oh, like British level. I didn't do the Olympics.
But... How did you do? You did okay?
I love it, but it was then like fashion stepped in and it was like, well, I can make money out of working.
Make money,
fashion.
You do.
So,
boxing
yeah.
Has the best people to work with.
Yeah, do you know, because I was doing all the figure skating fashion, which was good, but it was never at the level that like... Not pay-per-view level. Like, because you can sell things to the fans and get them involved and it's great, whereas with figure skate, the fans aren't really... Like, it's not the same kind of fan base as boxing.
Give me your top 5 pound-for-pound fighters in the world today.
Top 5? Andre Ward, obviously Floyd, who else, pound for pound, Errol Spence, when he beat Kel, that was really impressive, although like obviously Kel is back home.
I'm sure you put Joshua in there.
Joshua is obviously in there.
And one more.
But then he's like heavyweight, so you know, I have him beating the world. So
okay, so you have him number one
Joshua
no matter what. In his own.
Yeah.
He has great charisma. 90,000 fans is not easy in any sport entertainment to get 90,000 people.
But he gives, like, he'll spend all the time in the world with the fans because he gives back. It's like they love him. It, like, works both ways. Like, he wants to give them a good show and give them his time. Like, after he won, he went on this tour of the UK. like seeing all the fans, and it was so nice. Like, not many fighters do that.
One more name. Do you have Canelo in your top five? Do you have Mikey?
Canelo. Triple G. I don't know.
Or Triple G.
I'm an American. The fuck says this small? This could be your pajamas, so you can take it to London.
That's amazing.
Now, when you work out next time on Instagram.
Then I got you another.
My Instagram workouts are something else.
And then little tank top.
Oh, thank you so much. I have a present for you.
You can wear.
Fancy. Next time you wrap the hands of Justin Bieber.
Fight.
Someone famous.
Yeah, I'd love to make Bieber's. Yeah.
There was a girl from Australia who came here, and she started crying when.
So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekpak, reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter, at Sekpak. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Ellie Sekpak.